Some of you know that this is a microwave oven transformer. It steps up the voltage from 230 volts up to 2.3 kilovolts. Now, I do have some of the big ones laying around, so I decided to push the output voltage as high as it can. So for this project, I'm going to modify 4 of those microwave oven transformers and build a bigger one from scratch by keeping one single primary coil and all 4 secondary coils mounted on a single iron core. So after cutting the welds with an angle grinder and using the right hammer size and a few gentle taps, I have managed to split the first iron core. One primary coil is out, only 3 more to go. I have repeated the same process with each of the other 3 transformers and cut the welds very carefully in order not to damage the windings. I'm not going to lie, this is tedious work, so make sure to watch the entire process, the end result is definitely worth it. Taking these coils out, it turned out to be a real challenge, as they don't have any moving tolerance whatsoever. And those are some of the biggest transformers you can find on a microwave oven. I actually tried with some smaller ones that are more likely to be found on any average microwave oven, and it turned out to be literally impossible without damaging the windings. Now, with the first primary coil out of the way, it's time to remove the magnetic shunts. Their main purpose on such a transformer is to limit the magnetic flux through the coils, but we won't need them anymore as we are looking for maximizing the power output. 346 hammer strikes later, and the first secondary coil is also out of the armature. Now, with that out of the way, the next step is to repeat the procedure for the other 3 transformers. You would think that it would get easier with each and every one of them, as your experience and technique improves. However, strangely enough, that was not the case. As the core is so tightly packed and the friction was so high, it's almost impossible to remove the core in one single piece. Then, after numerous attempts, I found out that the easiest way is to break the core into smaller chunks in order to remove them one by one. This also makes it easier to reassemble it back. Here I'm cutting each end of one E-type armature part in order to isolate the core and the sides. You might not get the idea right now of why I'm doing this, but keep watching until the end because it will make sense soon enough. Now that we have all the necessary parts, it is time to assemble the final product. And although in this step I wish I was able to insert them in the same order it cut out, I was not inspired to do so while filming this video. So anyway, I carefully inserted all the parts of the armature one by one and gently tapped them into place with a small hammer. A pro tip here is to spray some lubricant oil on the armature before using the hammer. It makes them slide easier into place and reduces the chance of damaging the windings. Now it is time to mount the second coil and tap it firmly in place with a small hammer. The goal here is to reduce the space between them as much as possible, as to be able to mount all of the other coils one by one. Remember, there will be in total 4 secondary coils and 1 primary on this transformer. Now you can see why I cut the middle part of the armature earlier. You see, in order to mount so many coils, I had to find a way to extend the magnetic circuit of the iron core, such as to create an easier path for the magnetic flux to permeate into through the windings. If you have any recommendations of how would you have done this easier, feel free to leave it in the comment section. I would like to see your opinion on this. The fourth secondary coil is the easiest to mount as it does not get restraints from the sides. Now with all the secondaries in place, it is time to mount the last and final coil, the primary. For this I take a different approach as I mount it separately on the top E-type armature part. This process is kind of like the same as when I mounted the first secondary winding at the beginning of this video. Again, using some lubricant oil and some gentle taps with the hammer, and we get the finished top armature with the primary winding on it. At last, now it's time for the final two pieces of the puzzle, the side armature parts. This will complete the magnetic circuit and will provide a path for the magnetic flux to circle the windings and to return back to the primary coil. While having everything assembled, it is time to permanently weld the armature. Before that, I covered the windings with wet towels in order to protect them from any sparks and molten iron beads. This is the finished product after I weld it on both sides and let it cool to the touch. It definitely takes the danger high voltage warning to a completely different level. But before powering to the mains, it is time to take some low voltage measurements first in order to see what exactly are we dealing with here. So I will start by adjusting my variac to 20 volts, which I am going to feed into the primary coil. Then I am going to measure the output voltage of each secondary winding and add them up. So let's start by measuring the voltage for the first secondary winding, and we get around 179 volts. Now the second output coil is 146 volts, the third one is 137 volts, and finally the last coil is 126 volts. It seems the voltage gets lower the further away we move from the primary coil. This is due to something called magnetic reluctance, which is kind of a resistance in the path of the magnetic flux, the same way a resistor creates a resistance in the path of the electric flux. In our case, the reluctance is higher inside the points where the armature are welded. As you can see from this simulation, the magnetic flux density is highest near the primary coil, and it gets weaker the further away it moves through the iron. Also, you can see where some of the field escapes at the joints. Knowing that, after adding all the voltages we measured earlier, we should get a transformer ratio of 28:1. However, when I hooked the windings in series and measured the total output, my worst fear while working at this project came into fruition. A sudden voltage drop accompanied by some sparks while the secondary circuit is still open suggests that at least two of the windings have an isolation failure and are touching the iron core. After doing some more measurements, it seems that the first and the last secondary coils are grounded by the iron core. Now that's a bummer. However, I really want to see what this transformer can do, so in order to continue, I had to give up on the last coil, which reduces the ratio down to 22:1. Now, a standard microwave oven transformer has a ratio of 9.5:1, as I previously measured in my last video, which if you haven't seen yet, I leave the link in the description. Now let's get back to our setup. I will have this multimeter measuring the primary voltage, and I will use this variac to slowly increase the input voltage and see what's happening. Okay, let's get started. First attempt is with 17.5 volts input, which based on our calculated ratio will give us the output of almost 400 volts.
30 volts. Now we have a bigger spark. So let's put more, 50 volts. Now we have some dangerous spark. Let's put more. So 77 volts. We are starting to getting an arc. 104 volts. You can see now we already have a small arc. 110 volts. Have a bigger arc. 136. More. 149. 163. More. 77. More. 250.
At this point, I noticed some strange buzzing, which portends failure. Listen carefully.
Let's get to full power. 230 volts.
Oh well, you know what they say, guys, these devices run on smoke. If you let the magic smoke out, they stop working. After I did some measurements, it seems I have another coil that shorted the iron core. In total, I have isolation failure on 3 out of 4 secondary coils. Perhaps I should have taken the isolation issue more seriously and submerged everything in mineral oil. Nevertheless, this was an interesting project to try. If you wanna see more awesome projects, subscribe to this channel and activate notifications so you don't miss out on future updates. Bye bye!